We have been now many years in the Marc VDS, and of course, like every season, you need to decide what to do for the next one. And during the season, of course, we were talking all the possibilities what we had for the future. And I was thinking, okay, if it's good to stay in a Moto2, or if I have some possibilities in MotoGP, or what is the best way to go. And I was discussing with the many options, and then finally, like many other years also, I saw the best possibilities to have the good results in the Moto2 was with Marc VDS, and mainly there was two, three things that which was for me the most important. That the atmosphere in the team was really good all the seasons, and last year was incredible for us. And I also took the first win in a Moto2 last year, and the atmosphere in the team was perfect. So I wanted to stay in here, and also I had a few options in a MotoGP, but I saw that with this kind of the bike what they had to offer for me, I couldn't. I knew that I couldn't make the good results over there, and that's why Moto2 was the best option for me. And then the Marc VDS, like I said, that the atmosphere what was on the team, it was the main reason why I wanted to stay. And of course also the team already shows the potential what they had now for this season, and I believe that this will be the best for us. Yeah, that's really important to keep the same crew behind you, and for me, I think it's the now I can be really, really calm, let's say like this, that everything is on the good level now. And the other years was a little bit like the crew chief behind me changed, and we changed the bike shooter to Kalex 1 year, and there was many things that moving around all the time, but now we could keep everything on the same level like it was last year, and then we can concentrate for the small details, and we can improve the things what was a little bit weak last year. And I believe that this is the key to be on the podium constantly and try to win the many races as possible. This winter was a little bit different for me than usually. Like many other winters, I stayed quite a lot of time in Finland, I tried to practice with the ice bikes and try to be on the bike as much as possible. But this was a little bit different because in Finland we had quite bad weather during the winter, and we couldn't really make the ice racing. And then also somehow I decided, okay, I don't go to make anything else also. So I was on the bike really just a few days during the winter, and I hope that this is the key, that I can have the really good motivation now when we started the winter testing, and I hope that this is the best way to do it. I know that I have the experience already that okay, this is the front brake, this is the front wheel, and like this. So I believe that even if I didn't spend so much time on the bike, I'm ready to go. Yeah, last year we had a few weak points, and mainly from my side was always the qualifying and to really to push to the limit in the just on the one lap, and now this winter I tried to somehow concentrate a little bit a different way in my mind, and try to enjoy, let's say, try to enjoy a little bit more on the bike, and try to concentrate and focus for the right things, and mainly, you know, to be on this world and the MotoGP and ride with this best bike in the world, it's something that nobody really can have the possibilities. Like, there is just a few guys in the world who can have this, and this is the thing that you need to think like this, you know, this way, and try to enjoy for every day, and I think that's the key also for me, you know, to focus for the right things and thinking in the mental side a little bit different. And let's see, now the testing went really good, and also the qualifying time, or let's say the first outing lap or the second, it was already in a good level all the time when we went out, and I could be quite fast already immediately when we went out with the new tires, and I think this is the key to try to concentrate for these things, that immediately when you go out, even if it's the fresh tire, you need to be on the gas 100%. Yeah, it's absolutely the qualifying, it's the things where we need to improve for this season, and we were on the good level already during the races last year, and normally we could, if we finish the race, we could be in top five if we could finish without the problems, but mainly the weak point was the qualifying, that if we started out of top 10, it was so hard way to come back to the top five, and normally if you start from them, you need to push a little bit more, you use your tires more, and then for the last lap, when you try to attack again, the tires is already dropping too much, and so it's many way important to be good in the qualifying, and this is the key, I think, to fight also the victories, and I think the pace what we have for the race already last year, and I believe that also this year we can improve some things during the race, but the pace was good, but like I said, that the qualifying need to be better, and we focus for this. Yeah, it was different. Let's say that it was something that the feeling what I had in the past some years ago, and the riders normally they can feel it, that okay, if I'm now few tenths faster or few tenths slower, and now I got the feeling that for sure the lap time will be good, and then when I saw it on the timing on the bike, that oh okay, it was not so bad, but you could feel already on this lap that okay, now it's coming, if I can finish the lap without a mistake, and but okay, that's just the one lap, and that nothing really special, so we need to do this also during the race weekends. Yeah, of course, the other years I saw that the team Marc VDS was focused a little bit more for Scott, but this I believe that was okay for everybody, like the Scott was already in the team when I arrived to Marc VDS, and the atmosphere was a little bit that they was pushing more the Scott, but for me this was fine, like I didn't really care about this because I was try to focus for my things, and now when Tito arrives, of course many people and especially the Spanish people, they think that he can be the champion, and I believe that he can be, but this year it's my time, and I will make everything to be the champion. Yeah, there is a few people, that a few riders that I believe that they can be constantly good on the all the weekends, and like I already said, that Tito is the one of the guy for sure. I believe that I can be there, and looks like that Lüthi is really constant and fast. He was good in the winter test, and the Aspar guys, let's see what they can do. I believe that the Terol can be quite good. If he can be constant, I believe he is fast anyway. And the new guys from Moto3, let's see what they can do. For sure they have the skills to go fast with the bike, but to be constantly there on the top all the season, I'm not really sure if they can do it or not, but we will see during the race, the races and the season how it's going.